also by the argument of the national security being able to investigate itself. I'm currently dealing with one in which the Erastus issue. Yesterday, we had the military high command, and they've told us that they've done some investigation. And I told the Major General we met clearly that I left that meeting more confused than I came in. And that answers that we cannot expect people to be investigating themselves, and nothing would come out of it. So I would definitely, we need to be pushing for an independent inquiry.
So the Erastus issue you refer to is Erastus Asaridonko of the multimedia group who brought us the expose about some military men who were still deep, neck deep in the Galamse activity in the Ashanti region. And you know what happened? His recorders were tampered with and formatted and so on. And the military promised an investigation. They promised an investigation.
So look back,
how long has it been? What investigation has happened?
Some investigation, they said, have happened. And, you know, including the military, police and all of that. And they've... One of the things established was that these were military people that were sent there at the request of the district assembly, you know. But there are other questions that we want to answer with that. But that clearly, and you would ask yourself, that investigation happened, Erastus was not called, you know. So if we do this national security one and it's also just done at their end, really we will not solve it. So I think it's in the interest of Ghana, in the interest of all of us, that this investigation is an independent investigation. And I think organizations such as the parliament themselves should look into this. SRAG should also look into it. But it is important that national security elects an independent body completely to really look into this. And then for us as journalists, too, there are a lot of learnings that we need.
In the Emmanuel Ajafor case, the modern Ghana journalist, of course, one took a civil suit, and we are still in court. I'm his lawyer. Now, the ministry issued a statement. If you take that statement and compare it to what they have issued, the
template,
it's almost the same.
Template.
And they said we're going to investigate. Not a thing has been done.
Sometimes I think it would be good for journalists to go back and just look at when all of these things that are said, when they happen, and investigations are said. And you see, we should be people who should be guided by outputs of these things. And find out, you will find out that 99.9%, nothing comes out of that. It's a way to, just to tell you that keep quiet. Because when you go again, they'll tell you that they are investigating it. One of the things we should be seeking to do is to start elevating this conversation from just the civil suit and going to the West African court. We have seen it happen in the situation in Gambia, where the Gambia government were taken to the West African court and they were fined. I think it was $10,000, $100,000. We need to start elevating it. So if you have a situation where Latif is assaulted by a state institution, if you have the situation, Pius currently was shot by a national security operative, if you have situations where the modern Ghana people, we need to start saying that if it will not be dealt with nationally, let's go internationally. And then it would force our national body to start dealing with this situation. Okay. We need to also start teaching journalists a lot more about how to fight, come together, and two, how to also handle yourself. Definitely there are a lot of lessons that Caleb should have taught us about the way not to do some of these investigative pieces. But critically, it's one of the challenges that we are facing as a media is that now you are finding out that ad reportage is now basically assignment ridden. Ad reportage is now just your PR stories, but the critical stories that have to be told, and that's the portion of journalists. The Constitution tells us that we're supposed to hold leadership to account. And as for me, I define leadership very broadly. It's not just political leadership. It's all kind of leadership. And that will not happen. There's a media house that I know that has set up an investigative body. But currently, as we speak, all of those investigative, and they recruited even investigative journalists. Those investigative people, they're not writing anything like that. Because, and sometimes it's self-censorship by those of the people who are editors. And so the Kekubakus and the like, you need to ensure that you don't become extinct, that now nobody is replacing you. And that should be a cause of worry for all of us. And that will not happen if we continue to see activities like this where those who attempt to do investigative journalism are beating the way they are done. Because the freedom of the media, the freedom of the press, it's not something just for the media. It's for all of us. Because in this country, when things happen to people like Azugus and things when they leave power, they are not going to call any lawyer or anything. The first people they'll place a call to is the media house. All right. We all need to ensure that we can guarantee that space so that it will all inure to our democracy and the health of all of us.